Hello friends, how are you? Today I'm going to share some very important points about planning an experiment. The idea which I'm going to share with you will secure your 8 to 9 marks in planning paper, and that also within a few minutes. So welcome to my channel, Sony Singh Physics. Planning any experiment, we should take care about five things: hypothesis, variables, method — method means designing of apparatus and how to take the measurement — after that analysis, which include how to record the data in the data table, what will be the quantities on x and y axis, how to draw the graph, what will be the gradient and what will be the y-intercept, and after that precautions which has to be taken care during the experiments. So when we plan any experiment, we have to take care about all these five things. Friends, as you know that in A level physics, paper 5, which has 30 marks and 2 questions come in this paper, each question contains 15 marks. So in this video, I'm going to talk about question 1. Friends, if you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to my channel. Friends, through this video, I want to thank you to my viewers who had suggested me the topics for my videos. I am expecting that in future also you will keep writing your suggestions. Now let us move to the question. Friends, this is a question which I am going to do it now. It is paper 5, planning paper from October-November 2015. I am going to discuss question 1. Question 1 is: a beaker contains water and some metal blocks as shown in figure. A student uses an electrical heater to produce a particular temperature increase in the water. It is suggested that the electrical energy E supplied to the heater is related to the mass M of metal blocks by relationship. So this is the relation given in the question paper, that is E is equal to AM plus B. Friends, from my experience, I have observed that this relation is always based on either this equation, that is y is equal to mx plus c, or on the equation y is equal to mx. Right now this equation is based on this one, y is equal to mx plus c. So when we break down this equation, we can see that y, that is quantity on y axis, m is gradient, x quantity on x axis. Now when we see y is equivalent to E, so on the y axis E will go, that is electrical energy, and the quantity which goes on y axis, it is always a dependent variable. The quantity which goes on x axis, that is in this case it will be mass m, and it will be always independent variable. So when we know about x and y axis quantities, we can easily write that what will be the gradient, and in this case the gradient will be y by x, that is equal to E by m. So by just cracking down one equation, we can secure our 5 marks: 2 for finding the variables, 2 for the quantities which will be on y and x axis, and 1 mark for our gradient. This is the question which I am going to discuss it now. It is again paper 5, planning paper, October-November 2017. And the question is: a student is investigating the resistance of a light dependent resistor separated from a source of light by different depth of water as shown in figure 1.1. So this is the figure which is given in the question. It is suggested that the relationship between the resistance R of the LDR and the depth D of the LDR in the water is R is equal to 4 pi D square by K. So again our focus will be on this equation where K is a constant. So if you compare this equation with this one, this is Y is equal to MX. So when we compare both, we can see that R is the quantity which will go on Y axis, 4 by K is the gradient, that is M, and D square will be the quantity which will go on X axis. When we crack down this equation, we'll get the value for k that will be equal to 4 pi d square by r. So we can see that y-axis quantity will be r, which is resistance, and this will be a dependent variable. X-axis quantity will be d, that is depth, and which will be a independent variable. Since r is varying with d square, so on x-axis we will take d square, and now the gradient will be equal to y by x, that will be equal to r by d square. So again, by just seeing this equation, we can secure our 5 marks. This is the next question which I am going to do it now. It is again paper 5 question from October-November 2019. And the question is, when a light plastic ball is placed in a vertical column of moving air, the ball becomes stationary at a height h, as shown in figure. So this is the diagram given in the question paper, and the further instructions are, a student is using an air blower to create the vertical column of moving air. The student connects the motor of the air blower to a DC power supply. It is suggested that the relationship between the radius r of the ball and h is 4 pi r cube gh by 3, that will be equal to p into k, where g is the acceleration due to gravity, p is the power supply, h is the height, and k is a constant. So again, we have to crack this equation in the form of y is equal to mx. This is the equation, 4 pi r cube gh by 3, that will be equal to pk, where 4 pi g and power p has fixed value, k is a constant which depends upon r and h. When we rearrange this equation, we can see that height h will be equal to 3 pk by 4 pi g r cube. So 3 p by 4 pi g is a fixed number, fixed value. So when we keep it one side, we can say that h will be proportional to 1 by r cube. So h will change when we'll change this 1 by r cube. So next we can write that h will be equal to k by r cube, where we can consider k as a gradient. So we can say that the quantity which will go on y axis, that will be h, and it will be a dependent variable. The quantity which will go on x axis, that will be r, or that will be 1 by r cube, which will be independent variable. The gradient k will be equal to y by x, that will be equal to h by 1 by r cube. So finally it will be equal to h by r cube. So again, by just taking care of this equation, we can figure it out: dependent, independent variables, then gradient, y-intercept, and what will be the quantities which will go on the graphs. This is the next question which I am going to discuss. It is from October-November 2017. And as you can see in the question, these are two circular coil P and Q, and X is the distance between the coil. The relation which is given in the question is V is equal to V0 E minus KX, where V is the EMF, V0 is the constant, and K is also a constant, and X is the distance between the coil. Now again, our focus will be on this relation. When we crack down this relation in the form of y is equal to mx plus c, we'll see that so log e v will be equal to log e v0 dot e minus kx, and when you simplify it further, you will get the relation log e v, that will be equal to minus kx plus c. So the quantity which will go on y axis will be log EV, and the quantity which will go on x axis will be x, and m will be the gradient, and m stands for k over here. C will be the y intercept. So we can conclude with this equation, quantity which will go on y axis, that will be log EV, which will be a dependent variable. Quantity which will go on x axis, that will be x, which is a distance in between the coil, and it will be an independent variable. So by cracking just this equation, we can again come to know about five things about the planning question. And after this, the further questions will be very, very easy for you. Friends, I hope you have understood about the variables in paper 5. If you have any doubt about the content or any query, please do comment. Thank you.